السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We arrived back to UK after finishing our visit there, and we had to plan for aggressive awareness and fundraising campaign for Bosnia at that time. At that time, there was no difficulty of getting visa. People used to come there with no visa to London and so on. And Sheikh came with minimum amount of clothes with him, just something like this. And we put him in a hotel in London, and you know, he was asking us to buy shampoo for him. And Fadi was London fundraising manager and then representative. Said, how can he ask for shampoo? Shampoo is a very luxury. We did not know, because we are actually foreigners. We are actually like refugees came to UK. And those people actually use shampoo, but this is 1992. Shampoo for us was actually something we were using actually the sabun or soap and at that time. And but we made organized a very very aggressive awareness and fundraising campaign, and we decided to make a press conference in the Islamic Cultural Center in London. At the time, were actually NBC actually and other. A newspaper and other television and radio came and listened to the introduction of Sheikh Saleh Julakovic to the Muslim community and the other community in London, and how these things happened. And Sheikh Saleh was a diplomat, and he was trying to be very careful not to attack his neighbors from the Serb at that time, because nobody knew what's happening at that time. It was extremely successful tour inside London Grand Mosque and other places. And from London, we moved to Birmingham to do the same again and let him to speak in different mosques and different community centers to fundraise and to let people to be aware. So the thing about Sheikh Saleh is, for the first time, the Muslims in UK started to see some Muslims who are not Asian, some Muslims who are not Arab, some Muslims who are not African, but they start to see some Muslims who are European, with blue eyes, green eyes, maybe blonde hair, fair skin, whatever they call it. And the people are actually in a state of shock. But do we have Muslims living in Europe as that? Yes, we do. So, and from there, after finishing the program in Birmingham and Manchester, we sent him to Glasgow and Scotland to educate the people about what's happening in Bosnia at that time. While he is there preparing himself to try to raise the awareness and make advocacy for the case of Bosnia, I was planning with Sheikh Dabbagh in Qatar the second journey, or the second leg of the journey, to travel from London to Doha. And actually, we were planning going from London to Doha, Cairo. But while I was planning journey with Sheikh Dabbagh, he was visited by somebody from Bahrain, from another charitable organization in Bahrain. And when he knew that I'm coming with Sheikh Saleh Julakovic, he requested Sheikh Dabbagh to send our passport copy to him to get us our visa to go to Bahrain. And we did, alhamdulillah. Then we traveled, Sheikh Saleh Julakovic and myself, to Qatar. And this was at the end, or at the beginning, at the end of May, beginning of June, first week of June, we were there. And we were very welcomed by everybody there, very hospitable people, very hospitable country. And everybody was listening to the Sheikh for the first time to find that there are Muslims with blonde hair, with blue eyes, with green eyes, with gray eyes, with whatever you call it, come to speak to them in Arabic language as well. And it was a high-level visit, and even the visit was organized to visit at the time the emir of the prince, or the sheikh of the country, which is the late grandfather of the current emir. And they went to see him, and they bypassed me, and they said, no problem, let the Bosnian benefit from it. I was not invited to go with them to meet the Emir at the time, but they went, alhamdulillah, and we spent the Eid al-Adha there, which was 11th of June. And then from there, actually, we managed to plan our program to go to Al Bahrain later on. So these two stops, the UK as well as the Qatar one, were not planned. It was just Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who helped us bring the Sheikh with us and to go here and there and let people to open their hearts and minds and souls to receive his message, especially when he was talking to them in Arabic and to tell them about the plight of the people of Bosnia and the consequences of the war. Sheikh himself did not know the extent of the negative consequences and the damage which could have happened to his own people in the country, but it did happen, unfortunately. So we spent about a week or more than a week to meet the top class families in Doha, and we decided later on to go to the second visit into Bahrain. But I could not be able to comprehend what's Bahrain, what's in Bahrain. I did not realize that Bahrain visit would be far more better than other countries as well. I'll see you in the next episode when we arrive to Bahrain, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.